department at the program.
So essentially, you've heard today from the different modal administrations. In transportation, we talk about modes. So it doesn't matter how you got here today, you traveled on a mode. Maybe it was your 2 feet, so pedestrian mode. But we have planes, trains, automobiles, ships, you name it, the transportation department does it. So the research program looks at different technologies that would apply across the different modes of transportation. You have experts in aviation from the FAA, you have the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, crash worthiness experts, you have all these different disciplines, but at the department we try and coordinate over $1 billion of research across all of the different modes. So that's essentially the role of the RITA group. One of the offices, this is the office that really does the coordination, is the Research Development and Technology, RD&T group. So across the department, we look at common problems. If you're looking at position, navigation, timing, or communications, doesn't matter if it's a train or a plane, they all need to know where they are. So that's the kind of research we would do across the department to share knowledge so that one mode of transportation learns from the other, or we don't reinvent the wheel. So this is essentially what this group does. As well, they also work with what we call the University Transportation Centers, or UTC program. We do some alternative fuel research, remote sensing. The actual image you see there is actually an example of remote sensing. This is camera, LIDAR, radar information that can be used for surveying or construction or any type of purpose. So we do some of that research. And the RD&T group also does the National Cooperative Freight Research Program. They also look at alternative fuels. This is looking at ways of how does our next generation transportation system get away from greenhouse gas, fossil fuels, to alternative renewable energies. So I know a lot of you young folks are thinking about how can we make our transportation system and our environment better. Well, that's some of this research. So not exactly sure what each of your interests are. So I would say as we go through these slides, you may want to be thinking about if you're not really sure where your career is, but you have an interest in some kind of transportation, a research group is maybe a right fit because it cuts across all the different modes of transportation. It works with technology. And that's another thing that actually we need help in transportation is looking at ways to apply new technology. And I know a lot of you folks in the room are more savvy than me and my colleagues are, so we need your brains. Here's what I mentioned, the University Transportation Center program, the UTCs. This is research that's funded by the department with over 60 different universities, centers, and 76 partner universities that are all doing transportation-related research. So these would be types of universities that actually have a dedicated transportation department or a transportation institute. So if it's something that you're interested in this field, I would consider you to look at some of the UTC groups. And you can see from the map here, there are over 42 states have UTCs associated with it. So it doesn't matter where you are looking to go or live or study, there's probably a UTC center close by, so I'd encourage you to look at that. And again, all this information I'm providing you is going to be available on a website, so if I touch on something, you say, I wish I knew a little bit more, I'm going to give you the website at the end to follow up. Okay, so some of you may be in the audience saying, well, I'm not sure if I really want to be an engineer or transportation professional, I don't know, that may not be my thing. Well, we also look a lot at data. We do a lot of IT. Information technology, so computers, databases, all the data we collect. And when you look at the website and you say, well, you know, how many miles did Americans travel this year? Well, how do you know that? Well, the Bureau of Transportation Statistics would collect that. What about the airline statistics? Are airlines delays going up or down? How's the performance of the airlines? Again, the Bureau of Transportation, or BTS, collects all that data. So all the data, and essentially data is how we make decisions at the department, whether it's airbags or electronic stability control or any technology you see on your vehicles. How do we make those decisions? Why do we say airbags and not something else? The data. We have to collect the data. We have to make sure the data is accurate. It makes sense. So again, some of you folks are saying, well, maybe information, IT, computers is something I'm interested in. There's a role in transportation for folks like that too. And again, we also do other things with the data. This is how we make internal decisions, looking at freight. Again, we talk about the geospatial information. How do we use geospatial information in our decision making? And how do we also share that information and let others tap into the data and do their own research and make their own decisions? So we have a fairly robust data situation. The Volpi Center. Volpi Center is another organization that's part of RITA, the research group at DOT. It's located up in Cambridge, Massachusetts, right outside of Boston. And this has about 1,000 employees that do research, again, all the different modes, plus other departments and agencies. They do international work. They support all a host of federal departments. So again, if you're thinking, I don't know about transportation, I'm looking at sort of a broader education or environment, transportation cuts across boundaries. It doesn't matter if it's defense or the civilian world. People and goods need to travel. They need to travel safely and efficiently. And we have experts that are looking at ways to help international, state governments, other departments. So I'd encourage you to look at that. Training. We also do training at the university, at the Research and Innovative Technology Administration. We have a Transportation Safety Institute, TSI. It's located in Oklahoma City, and it's actually co-located on the Mike Monroney Aeronautical Center ground. So this is right in the center of the country. They do all types of training for the accident investigators. So when you have plane crashes or a rail car accident, any kind of accident, the TSI group does the training of the investigators. So they know how to look at what caused the problem, what are the solutions, and then filter that information back in on better standards or better designs. So a lot of transit officials, highway officials, the pipeline safety inspectors all get their training from TSI. Intelligent transportation system. So this is the office that I work in, so I'm going to give you a couple more slides on this. This is looking at how do we apply advanced technology to the transportation environment. I would say, coming from the transportation environment, it's hard to implement technology in transportation. You have bridges right now that are 100 years old. The technology, the computers didn't exist when they built those bridges. Same thing with our interstate system, essentially built from the 1950s out. So it takes a long time, and it takes a lot of work to keep our transportation infrastructure upgraded and maintained. As we upgrade it, as we maintain it, we're always looking at how can we apply technology. So the research that we do in the ITS is looking at wireless connectivity. So here's some of our... Somebody raise their hands if we've already gone over these numbers. I'm sure someone has. Steve, have we? All right, you know the problems. No mystery. Safety, efficiency, how do we get from where do we need to be? All the wasted time and energy and fuel because of either delays, congestions, or crashes. So these are the kind of solutions we're looking for. ITS looks at all types of transportation. You can see that there's, you know, rail, maritime, highway, transit, all the different kinds of transportation. How do we apply wireless connectivity for safety, mobility, and environmental benefits? So what does that mean? Okay. Primarily what we're looking at is a safety-based solution that we're working with our partners at NHTSA. They're actually executing the research where we're having cars talk to cars and cars talk to the infrastructure. Now we do that through this, but essentially it's a Wi-Fi signal. It's a modified Wi-Fi signal, but this is a situation where your vehicle would alert you to the fact if someone was going to sideswipe you or someone slammed on your brakes and you weren't paying attention, it would alert you that the vehicles are about to have an imminent crash. Same thing, infrastructure telling you if you're about to run a red light, the stoplight would send a signal to your car and warn you that you're not paying attention, the lights turn red, or someone else is running the light and about to hit you and have you slam on your brakes. So this is the safety research we're pursuing, but you can take that same data, filter it back through the websites or through traffic management centers, and operate the network more efficiently if you know the speed and location and the flow of traffic. And again, if you do that well, you'll save gas, you'll reduce greenhouse gas emissions, and you'll have an environmental impact. So that's essentially what we're doing. Now, I talked about the data. Here's where I'm talking about the data. We're creating a data environment through this wireless information, make it available to any mode of transportation, any researcher, any industry, where they take that data and they use it to increase the efficiency of our system. And again, that gets back to that number of, you know, why are we so worried about efficiency? Well, your delays. Every time you're delayed and you're frustrated on the road or on the subway, it's because there's inefficient operations. The more we can use data to enhance efficiency, the better our system will be. And with that, there's the website. So anything that I covered and more is on the website. I'll be here at the end, so if anybody has any questions for me or needs more information, I'll be happy to take your questions. So thank you very much.